بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Welcome my friends. I am Professor حسام الفلال from Mansoura University, Egypt. Our subject today is corneal endothelium protection during phaco mastification. With patients electing to have cataract and refractive lens exchange at increasingly younger ages, protecting the endothelial cell layer at all times is essential. Clinically, endothelial cell damage presents as early postoperative corneal edema ranging from mild to bullous keratopathy. Post-surgical endothelial cell loss increases up to 4 times normal rate in unoperated eyes and for at least 10 years, so corneal decompensation can occur many years after surgery. Toxic anterior segment syndrome is an infrequent presentation of endothelial cell damage. Limbus to limbus corneal edema plus mild inflammatory symptoms differentiate it from acute postoperative infectious endophthalmitis. We have to recognize the risk factors of endothelial cell loss. Number 1, advanced age, the cell count. The endothelial cell density is rather stable from age 20 through approximately age 50 years. After 70 years, the endothelial cell density decreases significantly in most people. Cell morphology. The normal endothelial cells are hexagonal in shape and are of uniform size. This gives the best geometrical fitting to the dome of the posterior corneal surface, yielding an efficient barrier. Long-term morphological changes of the endothelium include polymicrocytism, variation in the cell size, typically expressed as coefficient of variation, and pleomorphism, variation in the cell shape, typically expressed as the percentage of hexagonal cells. A higher variability in polymicrocytism and pleomorphism correlates with aging. Dense nuclear cataracts require more ultrasonic energy and prolonged surgical times. Also, they are more prone to turbulence and shattering during phaco mastification. They are technically more difficult to operate on. Glaucoma-induced endotheliopathy occurs with all types of glaucoma. This damage is more pronounced with high-tension glaucomas, such as angle closure glaucoma, pigmentary, neovascular, steroid-induced, viscoelastic-induced glaucomas. All filtering glaucoma operations and gonio surgery significantly compromise the corneal endothelium. Also, any ocular surgery, such as penetrating keratoplasty, intraocular lens implantation, pars plana vitrectomy with silicone oil, can decrease the endothelial cell count. All types of keratitis or iridocyclites are associated with endotheliitis, hence endothelial cell loss. Eyes with very shallow anterior chambers tend to have lower cell count. Intraoperatively, the short working distance makes the endothelium more liable to trauma. Hyperviscous viscoelastic, for example, Elon GV, may help deepening of the anterior chamber. Pseudo-exfoliation is characterized by a tetrad of zonulopathy, iridopathy, corneal endotheliopathy, and glaucomatous optic neuropathy. Diseases such as diabetes mellitus, renal insufficiency, and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease are associated with endothelial dysfunction. Peripheral cornea guttata is an aging endothelial change. When the gutti are present on the central cornea, it is pathologic and is an early sign of Fox corneal dystrophy. Mechanisms of endothelial cell damage. Though collateral tissue damage from ultrasonic energy is blamed to be a major cause of endothelial cell loss, yet mechanical injury of lens fragments and fluid turbulence in the anterior chamber are significant causes. Also, inappropriate treatment of postoperative inflammation and intraocular pressure spikes aggravates the cell damage. How to protect the endothelium? Pay attention to the predictors of endothelial dysfunction. Blurring of vision, a short period after awakening early, or difficult driving at night are suggestive of subtle corneal edema. Endothelial assessment is helpful in high-risk eyes. The endothelium maintains the clarity of the cornea by two mechanisms. Passive barrier represented by the endothelial cell count and morphology, and the active barrier of the sodium-potassium pump represented by corneal bathymetry. Specular microscopy can assess the count, the morphology, and the bathymetry. If a specular microscopy is not available, perform a pentacam bathymetry. A central corneal thickness more than 600 microns plus flat slope of the red line in the bathymetric curve are diagnostic of corneal edema. Then the OVD strategy. Because this coat contains chondroitin sulfate, the best endothelial coating substance, and it is highly retentive in the anterior chamber, it is recommended to use especially in high-risk eyes. Soft shell technique is helpful in these cases. This coat protects the endothelium and herein facilitates the anterior capsulorhexis. Dispersive OVD should be used frequently throughout the operation, but avoid complete filling of the anterior chamber. It may clog the Phaco needle port, heating the wound. Ensure complete viscous removal at the end of the operation, except in compromised endothelium. Avoid excessive wash and give anti-glaucoma measures for a short period. Maintain the anterior chamber deep and stable all the time. This is achieved via a balance between the irrigation bottle height and the outflow through the aspiration tubing and incisional leak. If fluidic parameters are okay and the anterior chamber is shallow, think about positive vitreous pressure. Exclude tight speculum, excessive eye movements, patient straining, and so on. Always keep away from the corneal endothelium. This dramatically reduces the endothelial damage. So, keep emulsification within the confines of the safe zone. This is a small area in the center of the pupil at the level of the anterior capsulorhexis. Here you are away from the corneal endothelium, from the posterior capsule, and from the rhexis edge. Minimize ultrasonic energy by using power modulation and the new technologies such as torsional or elliptical Phaco. Also, chopping techniques utilizing mechanical forces are more endothelium friendly than ultrasonic dependent techniques such as divide and conquer. Avoid tumbling or bouncing of nuclear fragments within the anterior chamber, as these fragments may brush the corneal endothelium. Also, intracameral drugs should be avoided as much as you can. If needed, should be of the proper concentration and should be injected in viscoelastic filled chamber. Though Phaco surgery yields a postoperative quiet eye, any degree of postoperative inflammation should be treated aggressively to help survival of the corneal endothelium. Also, IOB spikes following inadequately washed out viscoelastic is treated with beta blockers or alpha agonists. Avoid systemic or topical carbonic anhydrase inhibitors, as these inhibit the endothelial pump, thus aggravating corneal edema. Thank you for attention. Waiting you in the next lecture.